we've got our hands on the brand new Creality CR-10S Pro 3D printer. This is the latest in the 10S line and features a lot of updates that we'll talk about today. If you're familiar with the original 10S, then you'll notice some obvious differences with this Pro model. But some of the similarities that are shared are we still retain our 300x300x400 print volume. We still have our double threaded rods in the back. We can still print via micro SD card or direct line via our USB. And we still have our 0.1 millimeter precision. But for the changes or upgraded features, the biggest is really now we have this all-in-one and closed base on the CR-10S Pro. Now on the original 10S, you had a separate unit for your power supply and your display as well as your filament holder. So it was like having two separate units. Now we have just one base where everything is enclosed, there's less cables, there's less clutter, and there's less table space being used up. Now inside this all enclosed base, we have a 480 watt power supply. It is auto voltage selecting, so there's no switch on the side of the unit, but there is one physical on and off button and then just our AC cord port. In this base, you'll also find an upgraded motherboard. It's the version 2.4.1 TMC based motherboard. It features 256 subdivision trinamic drive for ultra quiet motor operation and precision. So the motors now are very quiet. They are ultra smooth, and the loudest component on this printer now is the cooling fan. So that is a big upgrade over the 10S if you're familiar with the operation on that unit. Another feature on our all-in-one enclosed base is our new display screen that is touch controlled. So you can just touch, and the GUI on the display kind of looks more like smartphone apps where it's an easy to use operation. The screen is nice and clear. It's a really nice upgrade to have no physical buttons here. Moving on up, the bed has some new features. Our max temp is now 110 degrees Celsius. Before it was 100 degrees max. Our bed also now features 16 point auto bed leveling. So when you go into the software and you configure the auto bed leveling, the head will come down to 16 different points and it will determine the height differences, and the software will control leveling the bed for precise printing. It's really interesting. Right underneath the bed, we have dual rails here for our bed to slide on with our belt right in the center. On the 10S, it was just a single rail in the center. Now, if we move up to our print head, this is a very small, uncompact print head. It features bigger fans inside for quieter and cooler operation. And then it also internally is our auto bed leveling sensor. Now, up here, we have our Capricorn PTFE Bowden tube for really smooth filament feed. And then that travels into our all metal double gear filament feeder. So we have gears on each side of the feeder feeding it through. It's smoother, it grips the filament really well. And this is an all metal construction back here. Back here on this guy, this is an all metal filament detector. So if your filament is running low in the middle of a project, it will detect that even with clear filament, and it will stop the print job and pause it for you so you can make your filament changes and then continue on. Lastly, on the 10S Pro, we have our resume print function. If something goes wrong while you're printing a project, if you lose power or whatnot, the printer will save and pause your project so you can resume it at a later date and you don't lose all your progress. All right guys, I hope you enjoyed this video on the CR-10S Pro, looking at the features and updates over the original 10S. If you have any questions or comments for us, please leave that down below. And if you want more information on this 3D printer or other 3D printers, accessories, filament, please check out the links we'll put down below for you too. My name is Brett with AMain Hobbies. Thanks for watching.